Once upon a time, in a lovely green castle far away, lived a real-life prince and princess who fell in love many years ago. How did this prince stumble upon his princess?
Well, this has been quite a drama. As I thought of it this morning, it actually first began in CU. There was a ministerial seminar, and we were discussing marriage. So Mrs. Nemhart asked, what am I expecting to find in a life companion? And I said, I need to find a woman who is a lady that makes it easy for a man to be a gentleman.
It was while working that Pastor Barrett met the beautiful Evadne.
I have been looking around. I was canvassing. Then I called at this lady's home in May Day, and then she asked me to visit with her. She invited me to her school to meet the teachers. I did. It was recess. But she said, no, it was a bad time. I should come back at lunchtime when the teachers were available. So I did. And she took over my canvas, took me to all the teachers, and I made a very good sale, etc. Then she said she needs something, but I should call at her home. And I surely did, and I haven't left.
And that wasn't it. They met again sometime later, but our prince had a little mishap.
We met at a lyceum series back at NCU. She had a little girl with her that Saturday night. So I asked her if it was her daughter. And she said, what? That's what you think of me? I nearly passed to ash. I felt so bad. But that actually knitted us. I said, no, I will have to erase that.
And indeed, Pastor Barrett found opportunities to make a better impression on his princess-to-be. She takes us down memory lane.
This poem entitled You was given to me by my husband just before we were married. So this paper with this poem is over 42 years old. I have kept it as a souvenir. I still read it sometimes.
You must be careful what you give women, because they will keep it. And I don't remember this at all.
Yeah, but I have it. And the last verse says, with all these kind thoughts of you, darling, I love you and ever be true. And someday we'll both be united and love and care for each other too.
Well, I tell you, I didn't know I was capable of doing those things.
And I also have the first picture that he gave me of himself. This picture here is the first one of myself that I gave him. This one.
It's romantic, like a woman, you see there.
Yes. Want to hear what he wrote on the back of it?
Mm-hmm.
Darling. No, my darling wife-to-be, if it's God's will, lovingly yours.
Right.
So after we got married and over the years, so we put back the pictures together. And I have the first one of himself that he gave me. I wrote a poem called My Valentine.
And so their love grew. Later on in the story, they both ended up on another island, and that's where the wedding bells rang.
She went to Turks, and when I went to Bahamas to canvas, I went over to visit with her, and we got married. Married out, overlooking the sea.
When we return, the Barretts tell us more about their wedding day in the exotic Turks and Caicos.